everyone, this is Professor Kim, and we're going to talk about some DC-DC converter topologies and how to remember them, but we're going to try something a little bit different, and you're going to see that I'm going to transform a little bit during this video, so here we go. I am a cat, and this is how we're going to proceed with this video. Okay, here we go. So we have three different converters, the buck converter, the boost converter, and the buck boost converter. But how can you remember how they look? What are their topologies? Well, the converters are all about the inductor. And you'll see we have these three different empty converters, right? The inductor, if you memorize the location of the inductor, then you can pretty easily figure out where the other two components are. So there's three components: the inductor, the active switch, and the passive switch. So let's look at the first one, and we're going to call this the buck converter. For the buck converter, we can just memorize that the inductor is at the output. So we can put our inductor at the output here. We need to get current to and from that. So we need to put different voltages over this one, and we have to let current flow. We also know that the current is gonna go this way. So we can kind of use our intuition from the fact that the buck converter and the boost converter are gonna have positive polarity, same direction as the input, so we can do that. Know our current's gonna go there. Then we know they have to put different voltages over that. So we know that we're gonna put our active switch on the top one, and so that's going to put our VIN connector and our V out over our inductor. And then the last one is a diode, and it has to go in the direction of the current, so that's going to go this direction, right? So it has to face upward. Next, let's do the boost converter. Boost converter. So this one, we can memorize that the inductor is at the input. Just memorize these locations. And then we know the current is going to be going in because power is going to be going into our converter here. So then we say, well, how do we change voltage over this inductor? To do that, we'd need to put the switch at the bottom, because then that allows us to put current through it, or voltage over the inductor. And then when we release it, the current's going to go flow with the direction of the inductor out. So that's our boost converter. The last one is our buck boost. And you guessed it, the inductor location is the other place. So it's going to be at the bottom here. Oh gosh, that's an inductor. Okay. And then we need to put voltage over that. Essentially, we need to connect it over the input and then over the output. So in this one, we will also be putting our switch here. Current's going to go this way. This one's the less intuitive one, but it's going to go this way, which means that when current is going to flow out, it's going to go positive and negative. So remember that our polarity is going to be opposite of that of the input here. So our current's going to go that way, which means that our diode has to go through here. Using that, we can remember that the inductor location is going to be different for each of them. For the buck, inductors at the output. For the boost, inductors at the input. For the buck boost, the inductor is in the middle going downwards. From that, you can figure out your switch locations, and then you have your topologies for the buck boost and buck boost. Have a great day.